नमः गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णु गुरुर्देवो महेश्वर गुरुस्साक्षात्परब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः गुरवे सर्वलोकानां विषये भवरोगिणां निधये सर्वविद्यानां श्रीदक्षिणामूर्तये नमः वक्रतुण्डमहाकाय सूर्यकोटिसमप्रभः निर्विघ्नं ब्रुवे देव सर्वकार्ये सर्वदा गजाननं भूतगणाधिसेवितं कपित्वजं भवपरसारभक्षितं उमासदं शोकविनाशकारणं भवामि विघ्नेश्वरपादपङ्कजं शुक्लाम्बरधरं अष्टं शशिवर्णं चतुर्भुजं प्रसन्नवदनं ध्याये सर्वविघ्नोपशान्ते व्यासं अष्टनक्तारं शक्तेः पात्रमकलं शम्बराशरात्मजं वन्दे शुकदातं तपोनिधिं व्यासाय विष्णुरूपाय व्यासरूपाय विष्णवे नमो वै ब्रह्मदेवासिष्ठाय नमो नमः नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरये। लास्ट टाइम वी आर लुकिंग एट स्कंदस बर्थ एंड वी लुक्ड एट स्कंदस फर्स्ट 5 days एंड हाउ ही बिकेम देवसेनापति। ही बिकेम द कमांडर ऑफ एंटायर सेलेस्टियल आर्मी एंड इंद्रस ही बिकेम इंद्रस फ्रेंड एंड शिवा कम्स एंड प्लेसेस हिम and says that whenever you need me and just remember me and you will have all the strength to do whatever you want to do. And at that time Devata started hearing a huge noise from this Dhanavas and Asuras started coming there and they started attacking Devatas and they heard all the voices of the Rakshasas coming there and attacking. And at that time, Indra and everybody started preparing for Indra told everybody, all the devatas, that do not be afraid. You will always succeed in this and take up arms and start attacking these Danavas. And with that assurance from Indra, all the devatas under his leadership, they started and going and attacking the Danavas. Huge battle took place between the devatas and Asuras. From Devata side, all the Devatas, 33 crores of Devatas, all of them with Murutas, Sadhyas, Vasus, everybody took angrily all the weapons and then started fighting Daityas, who came on their horses, elephants, and everything with all the sharp arrows and everything. They started piercing and then hurting those Daityas. Daityas also on their side, they started fighting angrily towards Devatas. And like this, the both sides fought with full strength, and they both sides suffered huge losses as well. At that time, a powerful Dharava with huge hands and huge body, holding a very huge rock in his hand, comes there and he throws. It's the Devatas with that rock. Tens of thousands of Devatas, army people, they crushed by that rock. Indra and everybody looking at that Rakshasa by the name Mahisha, they were all very much worried and they started fleeing from in all directions. At that time, Mahisha became very angry and he took hold of Rudra's chariot, Shiva's chariot, and then seized it and then held Rudra's chariot in his hand. Even though Rudra was held like that, he was not worried at all, and he just remembered Skanda. And remembering at that time, Skanda comes there, and Skanda fights this Mahisha and the Danavas on his own. With him at that time in that terrible battle, Skanda releases Shakti, his weapon. He releases that Shakti weapon, and with that, he kills Mahisha. He cuts Mahisha's head, and with that, he kills Mahisha, and Mahisha falls on the earth and dead. And with it, like a huge hill, he falls there. Like that, Skanda repeatedly releases that Shakti weapon, which every time he releases, it goes and achieves its objective, killing whoever is the Danavas, and then comes back to him and he releases that again. Like that, he defeated all the Danavas, and then the Danavas became very worried and they started running everywhere, and then immediately Devatas also got courage from this, and they came back and they fought with Skanda and defeated the Kauravas. So with that, Devatas won the battle against Dhanavas, and then Indra became very pleased, and he says he praises Skanda for his help and for his strength and everything. He says that you are just like Shiva himself, Shankara himself. You are such a strong person, and all the Devatas will worship you and will be favorable to you. And Shiva also at that time leaves that place, saying that anyone who worships me should also worship Skanda. So with that, Markandeya concludes this story of Skanda, saying that on that day 6, he killed all the Danavas single-handedly and became, he defeated everybody in the all the three worlds, and he was worshipped by the great Danavas. Markandeya says that any the Brahmana with due attention reads this story, the birth of Skanda and the first 6 days of Skanda, will attain the prosperity and in this world and companionship of Skanda hereafter. Skanda Loka, he will go to that, and he will attain that bliss after this world. So Markandeya concludes that. So again, here Mahabharata talks about the Danava called Mahisha. If the other Puranas, again, Skanda story, as I said previously, comes again later in Mahabharata, again, when we look at how gold was originated. Okay, so there is Skanda story almost repeated in many, many Puranas, and some Puranas again repeats many times. This is an important part in Shiva Parvati's story as well. And after Sati's went into Daksha's fire, and Parvati, Shiva married Parvati, and Skanda's birth. So all these stories come together. So Skanda's birth is very core to any Shiva story we look at. So the key thing here in this story narrated here by Markandeya is, as it talks about Agni and Swaha, giving Swaha, Swaha going in the form of Rishi's wives, and then that's how Skanda's birth coming. In all the other places, normally we hear slightly different version, which again comes in Mahabharata later in, when I said origination of how gold originated, when Yudhishthira asked Bhishma about that, how gold originated. At that time, we come to Skanda's story again, Skanda's birth. That time, the story narrated slightly differently, the same story slightly differently. And there also, we talk about Rishi's wives getting involved, but does not explain. So this is the one place where it is very well detailed and explained how Skanda's birth is result of seven rishis, and how seven rishis' wives were linked to Skanda's birth, and Agni and Swaha became father, mother of Skanda. So Markandeya concludes this story explaining about Skanda. Again, Skanda's birth is mainly to kill a daitya called Taraka. On the sixth day, he kills about Taraka. Again, in this portion of Mahabharata, we talk about Mahisha. Mahisha is again, he is the commander here. We are talking about commander of Taraka's army. It's not Mahisha, which Durga killed as Mahishasuramardini. Okay, so that's a different Mahisha. So the Mahisha here, Skanda kills, is the commander of Taraka. And then after killing Mahisha on the sixth day, he kills Taraka as well, because Taraka had a boon that he can only be killed by a young boy of 6 days, seven days or something like that. He had a boon. So that's why Skanda was born, and within 6 days he kills. So Mahabharata, in this section, it does not talk about Taraka's killing. So we will come to that later. So Markandeya concludes this story here. And then Yudhishthira asks Markandeya to narrate the different names of Skanda. And Markandeya then narrates those names. He says that the names of Skandas, again, he worships the rishis and everybody. And then he starts narrating the names: Agneya, Skanda, Deepti Kirti, Anamaya, Mayura Ketu, Dharmatman, Bhutesha, Mahishardana, Kamajit, Kamada, Kanta, Satyavak, Bhuvaneshwara, Shishu, Shigra, Shuchi, Chanda, Deeptavarna, Shubhanana, Amogha, Anagha, Rudra, Priya, Chandranana, Deeptashashti, Prashantatman, Badrakrit, Kutumahana, Shashti Priya, Parve, Pavitra, Matrika, Matrivatsala, Kanyabhatri, Vibhatta, Swaheya, Ray, Revati Sutta, Prabhu, Neta, Vishaka, Naigameya, Sudhishchara, Suvrata, Dalita, Balakridana Priya, Kacharin, Brahmacharin, Sura, Saravanodbhava, Vishwamitra Priya, Devasena Priya, Vasudeva Priya, and Priyakrit. So these are the divine names of Kartikeya, and anyone who repeats them will undoubtedly secure fame, wealth, and moksha. So that's how Markandeya concludes. Again, we hear Skanda most of these names in day-to-day life as well. And in Tamil Nadu, for example, he's known as Saravana, Saravana. So here are all the names. So that's again one of the names of Skanda. So he was born in a heat, forest heat. Then Markandeya again continues and he says that I will narrate the different titles of Skanda. So he narrates about those titles given to Skanda and he says different names here. So he says Brahmano, Brahmanyo vai Brahmajo, Brahmavicha, Brahmeshayo, Brahmavaratman, Varishtaha, Brahmapriyo, Brahmanas, Savrati, Tvam, Brahmajnyo vai Brahmanam cha Neta, Swaha, Swadatvam, Paratman, Paramam, Pavitram, Mantrastudatvam, Pratitaha, Shadarchitaha, Sammatsarastvam, Ratastva, Ratavascha, Sadvai, Masarai, Dhamasas, Tvam, Ayanam, Dishacha, Tvam, Pushkarastva, Aravinda, Vakraha, Vakraha, Sahasravatrosi, Sahasravaho, Tvam, Lokapala, Param, Havicha, Tvam, Bhavana, Sarvasura, Suranam, Tvam, Eva, Tvameva, Senadipati, Prachanda, Prabhur, Vibhaschapi, Adha, Shatrujeta, Sahasrabahustvam, Dharinitvam, Eva, Sahasra Stuti, Sahasra Tushtischa, Sahasra Bhukcha, Sahasra Shirasastvam, Anantarupa, Sahasra Patvam, Guha, Shaktidhari, Ganga Satatvam, Swamateva, Deva, Swaha Mahi, Kritika, Kritikananam, Tataiva, Tava Kiridase, Shanmaka, Kukudu, Kukutena, Yatheshta, Nana, Vidha, Kamapu, Rupi, Dikshasi, Somo, Marutas, Sadaiva, Dharmosi, Vayur, Achalendra, Indra, Sanatanam, Api, Shada, Shashvatas, Tvam, Prabhu, Prabhunam, Japi, Chogridhanava, Ratastya, Karta, Titija, Jantakas, Tvam, Jeta, Ripunam, Parva, Pravarashura Suranam, Sukshvam Tapastat Paramam Tvam Eva, Paravarjanyo Si, Paravarastvam, Dharmasya Kamasya Parasya Chaiva, Tvattejade Krishnam Idam Mahatmam, Vyaptam Jagat Sarva Sura Pravira, Shaktyamaya Samsuda Lokanatha, Namostu Deve Dvadasha Netrabaho, Ataparam Vedamigatimna Deham, Skandasya Idam Vipra Pade Janmasam Samahidaha, Shraveyad Brahmane Bhyoya Shunuyadva Dujeritam, Dhanu Ayur Yaso Deeptam Putranam Shatrujayam Tatha, Sapushti Dushti Samprapya Skandasayo Shayolakyam Anopyate. So he says that, so he repeats all these names. So it's Skanda's different titles, and Markandeya says anyone who listens this through Brahmana, this story of birth, and also relates these titles and names, they will have a long life, wealth, children, they will attain children, also victory, prosperity, contentment, and finally companionship with Skanda. So with that, the narration of Skanda's story, birth, and his different titles and everything concludes. So then the story slightly takes a different angle. So as we're looking at this, so when Markandeya came, at that time Krishna also came there, and then Markandeya started narrating about the creation of the all the universe, how everything, all the different yugas, and how at the end of Kali Yuga everything ended, and then the new creation started, and all those things. So Vishnu, Narayana, looking at all those things, he explained all that, and then he explained about the duties of women, and he explained the duties of what to do when one's birth order duty itself is clear, right? So that Fowler's story we looked at. Then we looked at the Skanda story and things. So Markandeya explains all this. While all that happening, so Satyabhama, who came with Krishna, goes inside with Draupadi, and they started talking about various things. Okay, so two ladies got together and they start talking about all these things. And Satyabhama at that time tells Draupadi that, what do you do, by what behavior it is that you are able to control your five sons of these Pandavas, Pandu's sons, how you control them? They are like Lokapalas themselves. How are you controlling this? How is it they always do whatever you tell them to do? They always do without getting any, without never, they never get angry with you. How do you do this? Is it, what is the reason for this? Do you practice some vows or something, vrata or something, or is it, do you do tapas, asceticism or something, or something you do with sweet speeches, or is it you give some sort of drugs to them, or do you do some sort of special knowledge you have and that's how you do it, or is it because of your youthful appearance you do it, or some recitation of specific mantras or something that are some vamachara you do it, or homa, or is because you dress up like this? What is this technique you have? Because of that, all your husbands are always with you and they always do whatever you want, what you ask them to do. So at that time, Draupadi says that, you asked me about the practices of the wicked women who do all these kind of things, what you said. So because they, and those things are not right, whatever you said, like, for example, drugging the husband or separate vows or mantras or chanting and things like that to attract the husband and make him pleased and do something for you, that's not the right thing for anyone to do. And you should not be asking such a questions and doubting me. As you are the favorite wife of Krishna, you should not be doing those things. And Draupadi says that when husbands learn that his wife is up to something and she is trying to get his attention, and because of that he's doing something, all these kind of things, magic or mantras and things like that, husband will become scared, and that person who is scared, he never sleeps and he never become in peace. Okay, he will never be in peace. So what is the use of those things? And Draupadi says that husbands will never be happy or made obedient just by sweet speeches and things like that. Again, some woman, she says that they take do everything for man become submissive to them, and because of that they do all the harm to husband. But she says that wife should never try to do any harm to her husband. And she says that, explains Satyabhama what she does and how she does. She says that keeping aside all the vanity and controlling her desire, anger and everything, she always serves her husband with devotion. And she also restraining jealousy and with deep devotion in her heart and senses of degradation at services, she performs without any sense of degradation. That never she gets tired of doing that service to her husband. And she waits upon her husband to instruct her and she does everything. She always again doesn't say any false speeches or sit, walk improperly. So, and never looks at feelings index. And she always looks at the what their husbands are looking for, what's in their heart. She looks at that and she looks, make sure that that's done. And again, she says that she never, again, in her heart, she never liked anybody, whether it is a devata or a manava or gandharva, whatever the ornaments and whatever how he looks, she never liked anybody else apart from her husband. And she says that she never took bath or never ate or slept before her husbands had done. And she always made sure that they have bath, eaten, slept well before she takes her own duties. And again, she says that when they return from outside, she quickly gets up from her seats and then does his salutations to them and then gives them water and seat. And she keeps the house very tidy with all the articles and food always prepared and well ordered and in clean. So the clean food is prepared always. And she says that she keeps the rice in the house, Anna, she keeps always and serves the food in proper time. So husband never goes hungry. And she never gets angry, fretful speeches, and never imitates women that are wicked. She never follows those women that are wicked. And she never goes idle. Okay, she always keeps herself busy and does what is agreeable to her husbands. And she never laughs at in jest and anger and things like that. She never laughs and never stays at a length of time at house gate. So again, outside, standing outside the house for a long time and things like that, or going to the calls of nature, she doesn't stay long, or in the pleasure gardens, so parks and things, she doesn't stay outside for long, and always refrain from laughing loudly, okay, and indulge in high passion, and also everything that may give offense. So she doesn't do any of that, and she always engaged in waiting upon her husbands and their instructions. And when her husbands are away, she never likes those kind of things. She wants always to be with her husband. And whenever they leave her alone, she just gives up everything. So all the dressing, makeups, everything that she used to do, she gives up everything and undergoes penances. And without whatever her husband doesn't want to drink or eat or doesn't enjoy, she never takes those things. And she says that, Draupadi says that she dresses herself in all the ornaments and she's controlled by the instructions that's important given to her, and always devotedly seeks the good of her husbands. And also she says that her duty towards her mother-in-law, what Kunti has told her in respect of the relatives and brahmanas and things like that, worshipping the devatas, worshipping the pitrus, and then doing food preparation on the auspicious days in the pots and then offering that to the pitrus and guests and things like that, services to those people. All this are known to her, and she always discharges her duties days and nights without idleness. So without getting tired, she does that. And without getting annoyed, she does that. Again, she says that personally, she waits every day with food and drink and clothes waits at her mother-in-law, Kunti. And she says that she never shown any preference for herself over Kunti in the matters of food or attire. Again, we hear this, my mother-in-law got a good sari than me. Okay, she got that jewelry, I did not get this. Okay, so Draupadi says, I never shown any preference over Kunti, and whatever Kunti gets, and that's the first thing, and then whatever after that they give me, that's what I always accept that. And she says that I never go against the words that Kunti has said. So she says that formerly 8,000 Brahmanas were daily fed in Yudhishthira's palace in gold plates. 80,000 Brahmanas, all the Snataka Brahmanas, household life, domestic life, they were entertained by Yudhishthira with 30,000 maids assigned to look after those 80,000 Brahmanas. And she says that 10,000 Yatis used to get food in the golden plates in Indraprastha previously. And all these Brahmanas used to recite Vedas, and I used to worship them with food, drink, and everything they needed. And all that I used to do. And again, my whole heart, I look with humility and approved rules. I used to do the truthful words to my husbands, and I used to do everything that they tell. Again, she says, eternal virtue of the woman, the punya for women, is based upon regard to their husband. Husband is wife's devata, and he is her refuge. And there is nothing else, no other else refuge for a wife. And she says, never again, she acted against the wishes of her husband. And in consequence of her diligence and cheerful readiness and humility, all these things, and also never speaking ill of her mother-in-law, her husbands became obedient to whatever she says. She says that Kunti's Yudhishthira in Indraprastha had 1,000 well-dressed maids serving him with all, they all decked in ornaments and everything else. And she says, Draupadi says, I knew all those girls and what they used to do and what they did not do, what they did, what they did not do, everything I knew. That means she's saying she knew everything that's happening in that house and that palace. So she had full visibility, and she used to have full knowledge of everything that's going on, like a housewife. And she says, and there are 100,000 maid servants daily used to feed the guests in the plates of gold plates. And Yudhishthira, when he lived in Indraprastha, hundreds, thousands of horses and 100,000 elephants used to follow his train whenever he used to go. So, not just looking at the servants, food, and things like that, everything she used to look. And what Pandavas used to do is throw upon all this burden upon her, and to look after and make sure that all these people are fed, and she used to do all that. And Draupadi says all this load was so heavy, and it was incapable of doing all these things, but I still used to bear all this day and night, sacrificing my ease. So I never had free time or anything, but I still did this affectionately devoted to them. Again, it is not forced or anything, but I did this affectionately devoted to them. And she says that when Pandavas were engaged in various things, whether it is penance or sacrifices and things like that, when they were engaged, she used to supervise the treasury. That's always used to get filled and things like that, but she also to make sure that everything is, whatever that donation, charity that needs to happen, she used to look after all that. And she used to serve those Pandavas in day and night. And she used to wake up first and go to bed as the last person. So that means she used to make sure that she wakes up before everybody up and does all the preparations for them to do morning bath and everything else, the puja and everything. And she used to go to bed after all of them went and they had good sleep. So Draupadi explains that this is my charm, and nothing else I did like any other things you mentioned. So hearing this, Satyabhama says that I've been guilty in asking you such a question. Forgive me for that. Again, just as a discussion among friends, I just asked it, saying, how do you control your friend? Is it some magic you do? Okay, that's how I asked, not in any bad intention. Forgive me for that. So Draupadi explains all this to Satyabhama. And then Draupadi again then continues explaining how to attract the heart of husband. So again, she says what she did, what's her duties are. And she now says, what is the way to attract the hearts of her husbands? And she says that you also do this with Krishna. So you will benefit from this. And Draupadi explains that there is no devata equal to her husband, equal to the husband. And because from husband, once husband is gratified, you will have everything. Every object of your desire will be fulfilled. But when he is angry, you will lose everything. And she says, when from husband, the wife obtains the offspring and various things that one wants for enjoyment. And also, from husband, you get good beds, seats, robes, dresses, garlands, perfumes, everything you want. And also the bliss, that fame that required here and after death, everything you obtain through the husbands. And that's why it's one should look after the husband. And she says, woman that is chaste, whether it is she obtains both happiness and difficulties, but you always look after Krishna and always adore him, and with friendship and with physical sufferings, every time always you adore him, whether it is happiness or difficulty, always adore him. And if you act in that way, offering him handsome seats, garlands, various perfumes and service and everything else, he would act in such a way that he thinks that this wife is really loving me and she really loves me. Let him think like that, act in such a way. And if Krishna comes at the gate of the house, immediately get up, go and open the door and make sure he's seated properly, give him the water, everything he needs. And she tells him, as soon as if Krishna says a maid that do something, immediately you go and do it and show him that you adore him with all your heart. So like that, do it. And also then important thing, so Draupadi tells Satyabhama that don't blab about whatever that you discuss with your husband. So you are with your husband, you discuss something in private, go and tell all your friends and other ladies and everybody, because when another lady or your co-wife or somebody hears this, that may not be what Vasudeva want to hear. Okay, he might have told you something, you don't go and tell everybody. Okay, so don't do that. And she says that feed everybody with your power and always seek your husband's good and keep him. But also make sure that anybody who is hostile to him and who is against your husband, who tries to do injury to your husband, and those who are addicted to desire, all those people, keep away from all those people. And she says that all these things, even when you are very happy, forging your excitement and everything, conceal all those things, observing silence when there is discussions happening, and discuss everything in private. Don't again stay with another person, even if it is your son, do not stay in private with them. And you should form attachment to the females of the highborn and sinless and devoted to their lords, their husbands. You should not always never go with the women who are wrathful, who are addicted to drinks or excessively greedy or thievish or wicked or fickle and those kind of natured women. You should never go with this. With this behavior, he will give you prosperity, and with that, you will always again worship your husband, dressing up fully, okay, deck yourself in costly garlands, ornaments, and everything else. Then worship your husband. So that's what Draupadi explains to Satyabhama. So while this discussion is happening, this again discourse from Markandeya was taking place. So Krishna and others, they prepared to leave, return to Dwaraka after that. So Satyabhama at that time goes to Draupadi and says that you do not grieve anymore. We know that you will get your kingdom back, and all the suffering you have gone through will come to an end. Yudhishthira will become the king of the entire earth. And all those ladies, Kuru wives, who laughed at you when you were leaving for forest, they will cry on their dead husband's bodies. They will cry. And your sons, Prativindya, Sutsoma, Shatanika, Shrutasena, all these Shrutakarman, Satanika, Shrutasena, all these born of Yudhishthira, Bhima, Arjuna, Nakula and Sahadeva, they are all doing very well and they are very skilled in weapons. Just like Abhimanyu, they are staying in Dwaraka and they are very much delighted at place, and they always go between Dwaraka and Panchala, and they keep going between those two places. Subhadra also looks after them very well, and she enjoys their happiness. She grieves for their grief, and she is there. Similarly, Rukmini looks after all these children just like her own children. So Krishna as well, with his son Bhanu, always affectionate those children. So don't worry about this, and my mother-in-law, everybody looks after them. So don't worry about them. All the Andhakas, Vrishnis, everybody, including Balarama, they are very affectionate towards your children, and they look after your children. So don't worry about them. So she says that, and then she worships, Satyabhama worships Draupadi and goes around her and does a namaskara. And then with Krishna, they leave to Dwaraka. So with that, we will stop today. Then we will start the next chapter next time. Any questions today?